Hi students, today let us move to the second unit, unit number 2, and the lesson name is 3 questions, the prose side, 3 questions. So before going to the lesson, let us move to the author. The author is Count Leo Tolstoy. What is the author name? Count Leo Tolstoy. He was born in the year 1828 and passed away in 1910. Means nearly 82 years he has lived his life. The Russian novelist. He is a Russian novelist. Novelist means, I told you the last class itself, a person who writes novels. Novels means imaginary things. He can imagine and write about the story. A long, a big story is called as a novel. And moral philosopher. He is also a moral philosopher. Philosopher means a person who thinks deeply about things. That is called philosophy. Example, studying fundamental nature of knowledge, reality and existence. That is called philosopher. A person who thinks deeply about things is called as a philosophy. Philosophy means it is a study of fundamental nature of knowledge, of reality and existence. So he is a moral philosopher. He thinks deeply. Ranks as one of the world's greatest writers. So among 10 ranks, he is also one in the world greatest writer, very good writer. His War and Peace, he has written War and Peace, has been hailed. What is it hailed? It is pellets of frozen rain falling in showers, like sprinkles, raindrops. That is called as hailed. From the heaven it is falling. So pellets of frozen rain, hailed as the greatest novel. So he's got that blessing. He's born, they tell her he's born with silver spoon. Like that, this person, Count Leo Tolstoy, is a hailed, is blessed of the greatest novel ever written. Then his ability of weave stories, his wonderful characters and his narrative capabilities are appreciated in every part of the world, even to this day. So all the people loves his writing, his wonderful stories, his wonderful character and his narrative. Narrative means the person who listens and tells about the novels or the stories. The capabilities are appreciated. The work which he does is appreciated in every part of the world. All the people, all the author, all the poets have appreciated him even to this day. Today also, if anybody reads about his biography, everybody likes his, likes him, his capability, and okay. So let us move to the glossary. Next, glossary. So I'll read the glossary. Listen, children, to the pronunciation, the meanings. Glossary means words and meanings in this lesson. First one, messenger. A person carrying a message. A person who carries a message is called as a messenger. Counsel. What is the meaning of counsel? Counsel means a group of people chosen to advise. Suppose if the king or a minister needs some idea, plan, like that. So he will call some wise people. He will select some people who got good knowledge and they will give him advice. So he can take that advice. He can choose which advice he can like. That is called as counsel. Third one, hermit. Hermit means a person who lives alone and leads a simple life. a person who lives alone and leads a very, very simple life. Woods, here in this lesson, woods means it is a small forest. A small forest. Woods. Affairs. Next one, affairs. Things, matters or business. Things slash then matters slash business. You got three meanings there, affairs. Next, beds. Beds. In the lesson, beds means it is small patches of ground for plants. So we'll tilt a little part of the land. Tilt means making the soil loose. You make the soil loose, then afterwards only we can, it is ready for the agriculture or planting seeds. That is called as beds. Okay, small patches of grounds for plants. Next, spade. Spade means tools. It is a tool for digging. They tell gadari, gudli, which is used for agriculture, plants and all. Next, fainted. Lost consciousness. Fainted, giddiness. They fell down like when the sun is heavy. That is called as consciousness. Lost consciousness. If they don't have breakfast. So that time also consciousness. So fainted means they feel giddiness. They lose their consciousness and they fell down. Next, seized, took away by force. Took by force, seized means taking by force. Next, faithful, loyal and true. Faithful means loyal, being truthful, being faithful, loyal and true. Next, fatally. Fatally, seriously, thinking seriously, talking seriously, being seriously is called fatally. Okay, the glossary side is over. Now, let us move to the lesson. Let us move to the lesson. Page number 31, unit 2. It is prose. Prose means lesson. The second lesson. So before you read, you got introduction. You got some introduction. Discuss the following points in groups and present your views to the class. So in groups, you have to sit and discuss what is the answer to this. The first point, the best time to do something. So in groups only you can discuss this one. You alone cannot answer. Because you'll be confused. The best time. What is the best time to do something? Morning, afternoon, evening, night, or the timing. 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, a.m. or p.m. Which is the best time to do something? Any good things? Next. The most important person in your life. Who is the most important person in your life? Maybe your parents or teachers or your grandparents or any ministers. The most person you like. The most person you like or important person. So which is the person you liked? They may be an example for you. Who is that person? Okay. Third point. The most important thing to do in your life. After you are born. Before you die, after you are born, before you die, before your death, which is the most important thing which you have did in your life? Achieved or did or what else? Which is the most important thing in your life? What you have did in your life? Which is that achievement? What is that achievement? Come on, discuss and tell. Only one answer we need for this. Each point, one answer. No options and all. Okay. Understood, children? The introduction. Next, going to the lesson. The first para you got. The thought came to a certain king that he would never fail if he knew three things. So here the lesson name itself is three questions. The lesson name, I told you, three questions. The author is Count Leo Tolstoy. So once what happened? The king, a certain king, a good king, a king, to the king mind, this thought is coming. What is that thought? First three things would never fail. What is the three things? If he knew the three things, it will never fail. He will never fail in his life. What is that? The first question, what is the right time to begin something? What is the right time to begin something? To start some program or some new things like that. A good program, traditional program. So what is the right time? Morning, evening, afternoon, what is the time? The first question. So if you knew this question, the answer to the question to the answer, he will never fail in this life. Second question, who should a king listen to? Who should a king listen to? Whether he has to listen to his parents or God or who? King or who? You have to listen. The third question, what is the most important thing for a king to do? I am a king now. Which is the most important thing that I should do for my people? I should do for the country? I should do before I come down from a king? So these are the three questions. These are the three questions that came to the king's mind. So if he know the answer to these three questions correctly, exactly, the king will never, never fail. He will have a very good response. He will have a very good name, a very good fame. He will be known by the people, very popular to the people. This king was very good. This king had knowledge. This king did this. So like that he want to get response from the people. So he asks these three questions. He wants the exact answer, the right answer. Okay. The king therefore sent messengers throughout his kingdom. The king therefore, he doesn't know the answer, proper answer. He got answer, but he doesn't know whether it is correct or not. So he sent messengers. Go tell to all the people throughout the kingdom. Throughout the kingdom, my kingdom. That I want the answer. Promise the people. Promise the people. I will give them some amount of. Anyone who could answer these three questions, I'll give some amount, large sum of, to anyone who answer these three questions. So what happened? Many wise men came to the king, but they all answered his questions differently. Many, many wise people, means knowledgeable people, very clever people, educated people, those who have knowledge, everybody came to the king, but all the answer was different. Nobody is giving the same answer. He wants at least three or four people giving the same answer, but all the answers are very different. Next. Second para, children. First para, I think you have understood. Let us move to the second paragraph. I'll just read, children. Read, and along with that, I'll explain to you. In reply, so many people, wise men came. They answered, but the king was did not satisfied. The king was not satisfied. The king was not satisfied with their answer. In reply to the first question, the answer he got for the first question, some people said, the king must prepare a timetable. The king must prepare a timetable and then follow it strictly. Now how we are having in the school, first period math, second period science, third period social, like that, the king should prepare timetable exams. Morning he have to do account work, afternoon you have to look after the people, third he have to go around the kingdom, like that you have to prepare your timetable exams and follow it strictly, then he will get a good name. Others, some other wise people said that it was impossible to decide in advance. So some others are telling this is not correct, preparing timetable is not correct. Suppose you prepare a timetable, next morning you could not do that. Suppose you are unable to do that work. If you are unable to do that work, what will happen? It is impossible. You cannot write the timetable and prepare like that. You cannot follow it correctly. The right time will not do that. Okay. Then the king should do whatever seemed necessary at that time, some other people told. Then means whatever he likes, he have to do necessary things, good things he have to do. Yet others said, other people also said, that the king needed a council of wise men who would help him act at the proper time. So some people are telling he should have a council of people. Council of people. Council means, I told you, a group of wise people who tells him to do good things. So that people he should have, and he should ask them what to do. Then he have to do it. What to do? He have to do it. So this is the proper way, some people told him. But then others said, still others are telling that there were some things which would be urgent. Suppose if the council of people tell him and he has some another urgent work, that also will fail. That also will fail. These things would not wait for decision of the council. We cannot wait for the council. The council will also fail. In order to decide the right time for doing something, it is necessary to look into the future. And only magicians can do that. The king, therefore, would have to go to the magicians. Some other group people are telling, some other wise people are telling, this is all impossible. The king should go to a magician, magic man. He will tell what to do. He will know the future of the people. So if he tells, so that work he can do. So he should have some magicians and look for his future. In their answer to the second question, the first question is over. So the conclusion is what? He have to have some magician. Coming to the second question. In their answers to the second question, some said that the people most necessary to the king were the counselors. Others said priest. A few others chose doctors. And yet others said that the soldiers were the most necessary. What is the second question? The second question is, who should a king listen to? The second question is, who should a king listen to? For that, the answer the wise people are giving, that they should listen to a council, counselors. They are the very good people. Some others are telling priest, because he is very having knowledge and very, very, what is that, soft patience. So priest. And some others are telling, no, it is doctors. If you listen to the doctor, your health will be good. So doctor is a good person. And yet others said, no, it is soldiers. You should obey to the you should listen to the soldiers, because they are fighting for our country. They are giving their life for our country, sacrificing their life, sacrificing everything. So soldiers are the most necessary people, he's telling. The wise people is telling to the king. Next, third one, third question. What is the third question? What is the most important thing for a king to do? What should a king do? Important thing for the people or for the others or for who? What he should do? The king, what he should do? The important work. The important work. For that, the wise people are answering. As the answers to the third question were so different, the answers were so different. The king was not satisfied. He decided to seek the advice of a certain hermit who was widely known for his wisdom. At last, the king decided. The wise men are not giving answers properly, correctly. He is not satisfied. So the king decided, he himself decided, I have to look, seek means I have to look for the person of certain hermit, for certain hermit, advice of a hermit. I don't want the advice of the wise men. I want the advice of the hermit. I told you hermit means a person who is living alone, not mingling with other people, laughing, talking, chit-chatting. So he will be thinking about knowledge, about something else different. So I want the person, hermit, and he will also live a simple life. He will not be very grand, proud, like that. He will be very simple. So I want a hermit. I don't want any wise men. The king decided and he went. Who was widely known for his wisdom? Hermit is also known for a wisdom, means knowledgeable person. Coming to the third para. The king put on ordinary clothes and went to meet the hermit. The king disguise. He's not going like a king wearing all the jewels, sitting on a camel or a horse. Not like that. He's very simple, ordinary people. All the people are living in his kingdom like that. Ordinary clothes. He wore very ordinary clothes, not very grand or good. Ordinary clothes. And went to meet the hermit. He is going to meet the hermit, that person. Before he reached the hermit's hut, before he could reach that person, hut home, what happened? The king left his horse with his bodyguard and went alone. So he leaves the horse to his bodyguard. He brings bodyguard with him. He comes in the horse and he leaves that to the bodyguard. And he is coming very, very simple to the hermit, to the hermit's house. And went alone. He is going alone without anybody's support, without any person, servant also. As the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted the king and continued digging. So what happened? As the king came near the hermit's house, hut, he saw the hermit. What is the hermit doing here? He is digging the ground. He is digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted. Greeted means welcome. He is welcoming the king. He greeted the king. Welcome, sir. Please come, sir. He greeted and continued digging. He just told, welcome, sir. Come, sir. And he started doing his work. The king went up to the hermit and said, I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. And he repeated the questions. So the king went near the hermit and said, sir, I have come to you. You are digging. I have come to you only. You look at me. I have some doubt. Wise hermit, knowledgeable hermit, To ask you the answer, I have three questions. Please give answer. And he repeated the questions. First question, second question, third question, he repeats. The hermit listened to the king. The hermit listened to the king, but he did not speak. He did not speak. He listened to the question. The king is asking. You are tired, said the king. The king is asking, are you tired? You are not answering anything. I am talking. You are not answering anything. Let me take the spade and work in your place. Okay, give the spade. I will dig. I will do the work. Come on, answer to my question. Give the spade. Thanks, said the hermit. He gave the spade to the king and said, thank you. And said the hermit. Giving the king the spade, he takes it and you dig. Thank you. When the king had dug two bed, two steps of the ground, he stopped and repeated the question. The hermit gave no answer. The king is digging the bed, the ground, two beds he has digged. He stopped and he repeated the question. King repeats the question. The hermit did not give answer at all. Okay. Here, I'll listen. Next class, I'll continue, children. This is your homework. The four questions. Answer these questions. Next class, I'll continue the lesson. The first question, what thought came to the king? Second question, write the three questions for which the king wanted to have answers. The third question, was the king satisfied with the answer? If yes, why? If no, why? You have to give the reason for both. If you write yes also, you should give reason. If you write no also, you should give reason. The fourth question, who did the king decide to seek advice from? That's all, children. Okay. Thank you, students.